Democracy is broken, let's fix it. And it's been broken since the very beginning. Socrates was killed democratically. Socrates openly espoused certain anti-democratic views, most prominent perhaps being the view that it is not majority opinion that yields correct policy but rather genuine knowledge and professional competence, which is possessed by only a few. Socrates set the basis for the future techno-meritocracy. Democracy has been broken very especially since the military-industrial complex, as Eisenhower warned us in his famous speech in 1961, and a bunch of psychopaths and ignorants have taken our lives and the lives of our beloved ones as well as the lives of several billion people buried in life. This is our state-of-the-art pyramid as human species. The world's 62 richest people now own as much wealth as the 3.6 billion people who make up the poorest half of the global population. Almost 1 billion people are undernourished or lack vitamins and minerals. Is that really the absolute very best that we can do after more than 300,000 years of evolution as Homo sapiens and 3 million years since the first Homo habilis? Do you still think that democracy is the absolute very best way to rule the world? If not, please keep on watching. Welcome to the Techno-Meritocracy. These are the two central tenets of the Techno-Meritocracy. 1. We are not all equal. The vote of a psychopath or an ignorant can't be equal to that of a decent citizen. 2. Only the scientifically proven best and most skillful, the most honest, generous and willing to serve people in the world should rule us. This is how to hack the planet in one line of code. With a blockchained artificial intelligence and deep learning self-organized system based on a mutating H-index type algorithm. If you don't agree with that, please stop watching now. Thank you for your time. If you do agree with that and feel curious to know more, please keep on watching. Thanks. I feel curious and want to know more. In the Internet Galaxy, 2001, Manuel Castells. Through the 2000-2014 research survey of the Social Sciences Citation Index ranks as the world's 5th most cited social science scholar, and the 4th most cited communication scholar in the world, talks about the network society culture being techno-meritocratic, for hackers and virtual communitarians, and entrepreneurial. You have to be crazy to question democracy. Very, very crazy, or you are going to have to fight against 2.5 thousands of years of mental and political conditioning, and not everybody is ready to dare to get rid of the beliefs and prejudices that the family, the school, the college, the laws, the culture, have unconsciously programmed us with. Albert Einstein once said, "It is harder to crack a prejudice than an atom." And you are going to have to fight not only with yourself but against the others. For almost nobody is ready to be unplugged from this subtle prison for our minds. When you face others in denial regarding this idea, you have to remember two things. Patience. Perseverance. The game 23, dangerous idea 23, let's build by mind 23, a worldwide techno-meritocracy. The most apt, the most sage, intelligent, the best prepared, technically or artistically minded, in any of the branches of human knowledge, in the trivium et quadrivium spirit, and also the most kind, generous and willing to serve the others, as tagged to be the best ones by others like them, will jump straight to the top of a techno-meritocratic pyramid to manage and administrate world material and human resources worldwide. How? Hacking the planet with one line of code. With a blockchained artificial intelligence and deep learning self-organized system based on a mutating H-index type algorithm. Imagine. This is only a draft for the implementation of the idea. The idea has to be implemented by a community of hackers and experts and not by a single individual. Now, imagine a pyramid of excellence and nobility with 10, just to say a number, super sages, conscious scientifics and artists, all powerful, each one of these an expert in one branch of human knowledge, in the liberal arts education, in the trivium et quadrivium style, whom were tagged and chosen to be the super sages by the human community, according to an H-index type algorithm. The H-index is an offer-level metric that attempts to measure both the productivity and citation impact of the publications of a scientist or scholar. This could be used to implement a kind of page rank for people, where the people most knowledgeable about a subject would ascend steps in the pyramid and whose tags/votes would carry more weight in the algorithm to be computed by an artificial intelligence system than those on the base of the pyramid. Imagine that those super sages could be rotating each certain time, in order to avoid corruption or abuses of power, as determined by the Council of Computer Scientists in charge for the development of the algorithm. Imagine that the algorithm was used so that those 10 super sages or experts could designate other sub-experts, who would designate other sub-experts one step below in the pyramid to assist them, whom could designate further sub-experts down the pyramid, and so on and so forth. Ellipsis points in order to work with concrete and urgent issues such as the search for the cure of cancer or any global catastrophic risks such as the imminent threat of climate change. Maybe the fact that trusting 10 super sages on top of the pyramid to manage the planet thanks to an artificial intelligence permanently mutating in its algorithm might sound a bit dystopic, right? Well, that's an easy one. Let's try and see what happens. That's the hacker attitude, right? How to test the validity of this dangerous idea 23. First, an anonymous The Game 23 agent wondered who might be the best person in the world to understand this idea. They needed only the absolute very best, in the same spirit that we would do if we had the system already built. This is Jeff Dean. Jeff Dean, computer scientist and software engineer. He is currently the lead of Google.ai, Google's AI division. Due to his impressive background and expertise, and as lead of Google's artificial intelligence division, Jeff seemed to be exceptionally well-positioned to understand the idea. Several years ago, on Monday, November 9, 2015 at 11:43 a.m. an anonymous The Game 23 player sent these 10 lines of code to Jeff Dean. Hi Mr. Dean. Have you considered building a page rank for people? Imagine the following scenario: a meteorite is detected and it is predicted that it will hit the Earth in 24 months. Suddenly, a worldwide challenge arises to arrange a team in the shortest amount of time with the best engineers in the whole world coordinating world resources in order to work together towards deviating / disintegrating such threat to human survival. Idea: a kind of an H index would solve this in the shortest amount of time. A reputation engine that would rank items where items equals human beings or products, according to a certain parameter, be it trust, skillfulness at mathematics, knowledge about meteorites, leadership, honesty, etc. In our view, this could hugely improve the world for the better, not only to deviate meteorites but to manage anything from running a company to running nationwide governments. Question: do you see this as impossible to code? If you want more info, please let me know. Regards. The Game 23 player. Jeff Dean kindly replied to that message on November 10, 2015, 5:14 a.m. Hi The Game 23 player. I've thought about similar things a few times. I do think there are lots of benefits in getting people with similar interests that don't otherwise know each other or interact to do so. Unfortunately, I haven't had a lot of time to work on this. I think that one would really want it to not be a single page rank value per person, but rather a context-sensitive value, depending on what kinds of expertise was of interest. Someone that knows a lot about the structure of concrete should be very high in the context of answering materials sciences kinds of questions, but probably low in the context of answering psychology questions. A good place to start might be to use large corpora of published scientific articles as the way of computing this information. Unfortunately, I'm busy enough with other things that these ideas remain mostly just occasional thoughts rather than an active project. -Jeff. Excellent. Jeff Dean not only understood the Game 23 player's idea but he actually shared some ideas about how to improve it. Unfortunately, and understandably, he is quite busy to develop it. Thank you Jeff. Then that the Game 23 player thought that it was needed to contact the absolute very best person in the world to understand blockchain and cryptocurrencies. That person was that genius called Vitalik Buterin, obviously. Co-founder of Ethereum, the blockchain platform. Vitalik Buterin, born January 31, 1994, is a Russian-Canadian programmer and writer, primarily known as a co-founder of Ethereum and as a co-founder of Bitcoin Magazine. On Monday, May 2, 2016 at 5:45 a.m. that the Game 23 player sent to Vitalik the same email that they sent to Jeff Dean. He got back on Tuesday, May 3, 2016, 12:48 a.m. with the following reply. Sounds like what you're describing essentially is what we call a decentralized reputation system. So yes, quite doable on Ethereum, and there may be groups trying to do it already. Great. Vitalik also understood the idea and even assured the Game 23 player that it could be done on Ethereum. Thank you, Vitalik. The Game 23 player got the two confirmations that they needed, now the system was ready to run on its own. Something like this would definitely change the world for the better. From the technological to the economics, to the political, the ethical and even the philosophical, now we know that it is doable. I like this Hive Mind 23 idea, how can I help? Share this idea and this pass to Bin and spread the message with these hashtags, hashtag HiveMind23 and hashtag TechnoMeritoCrazy. Create some original art, be that an image, a wallpaper, a YouTube video, an MP3, featuring the Game 23 and the Hive Mind 23 idea. Speak about it in boards and social networks. Send a kind email/tweet/PM to experts you know, introducing the idea. Start an Etherpad, GitHub, board, whatever and begin to politely brainstorm and discuss design and code ideas with fellow hackers. Monitor hashtag TheGame23 and you will be updated with news as they happen. Join TheGame23.com and you will be updated with news as they happen. Back. Is HiveMind23 the perfect system of government? No. None is. But we firmly believe that, as Socrates sharply suggested, and even died for it, this is the least bad. Is this a techno-crazy? No, this is a techno-merito-crazy. Is this a merito-crazy? No, this is a techno-merito-crazy. Is this a Black Mirror episode like Nosebind? No. Is this going to work like the social credit system in China? No. Not at all. Actually, this is the polar opposite to that. Why you don't have the answers to all the questions? Because we are only humans. Instead, we want all of us to politely dialogue, brainstorm and answer as many questions that we all pose about strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats of this dangerous idea together. The anonymous The Game 23 player who originally sent those several hundred mysterious emails from 2014 to 2016 has released this idea into the public domain in order to guarantee that we don't pursue any material benefits with it at all. Once it's been released, the idea doesn't belong to us anymore, it's absolutely free for you to act upon it. Or not. Final thoughts. We, as the global humankind that we are, face global challenges of an imminent urgency, such as climate change and a million other problems. With millions of children dying of hunger each year, this cannot be the best of all possible worlds, as Leibniz suggested. We must have done something terribly wrong. Are we really thinking that thanks to democracy in all its splendor, we prefer, as it's been already proved to be the best type of systems of government, after more than 300,000 years of evolution, to have in the apex of the pyramid in order to set the destiny of the world to this? Thank you. Imagine.
Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them. Because they change things. They push the human race forward. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world